our brother, he has almost said virtually everything. Mazi, where are the securities of the town? Somebody is the security of the province or state, and they may call it. We go by. Where is the security? Where are the people from Anambra State? Where are the securities, Mazi? This happened since morning. They have been attacking this place. Mazi, what has the army got to raise the buildings? And even the one that has been new house, they went back, they raised every...
I don't know what is going on. The contraction called Evil Forest Call Nigeria. They are not happy. Go ahead.
I can hear you. Yes, I can hear you clearly, my brother. Leaving from here.
Where are you calling from and your name, please?
My name is Kikut. I'm calling from Ubo. They know me as Madam Shedra. And, I'm calling you right now from Ubo. In Onika province of Biafra land. Man, this is a very sad day, I must say. I was in my working place when one of our brothers from Asaba called me and said that I should go online and see what is going on. But one thing is sure here. Biafra must understand that our life is being threatened by the Nigerian government. That is why they are pushing for get this bill by a Fulani man in the Senate. He's trying to, you know, to stop people from reporting the atrocities like that because they have planned it. I told our people that when the people said that they are going for security meeting, that they are going for a family meeting, because when you look at the security chief, they are one Fulani extraction. So they go to this meeting, they plan on what they are going to do. And which, of course, they are going to execute. Nobody will stop them. That is why they are bringing down their soldiers down to our land. Where there is no crisis, where there is no war going on, they are bringing soldiers here. People need to explain to us why Nigerian soldiers and their police will go to our brother's house to do what? To kill our people. We must understand that there is no time for us to be, you know, pretending with these people. If you have these pictures, you must keep on posting it and keep on tweeting it to all the head of state. That is ma. Because that it will happen, our leader will tell you. It's because it must happen. It must surely happen. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mazi. Adia Mama, if it happened to our barrister today, it might happen to you. Let's go to the caller on WhatsApp. Caller on WhatsApp, can you hear me? Caller on WhatsApp.
It's a privilege to serve the indigenous people of Biafra. My name remains Mazi Tony Asomba, reporting from Omambala, Biafra land. Today has been so hectic for Biafrans here in Omambala. The situation on ground, regards to what is going on in to our Ebo lawyer, Barrister Ifeanyi Ijeofor. The police and force, joint combined service of Nigerian forces, invaded his house early morning, this 5 o'clock, as early as 5 o'clock this morning. And their mission is to terminate his life, because they proved that his house on the day he buried his younger brother, they came around him and since then they've been sending troops to make sure that they assassinate his life, to assassinate him. But today it was a different thing. Early in the morning, by 5 o'clock, they came. And by the time they got there, some of our men on ground could not allow, give them the opportunity to break in to assassinate our barrister. At that point, there was a kind of exchanging of bullets. They started shooting rampantly to everything that wear cloth on his body. They started shooting, and our boys were very, very on ground to resist most of their games. At the process, they left. By the time they came back with 6 armored tanks and almost 50 helos loaded with armed men, And what they could do was to go in there and burn the whole house down. Every building within his premises were burnt down this evening. They came back again and burnt his brother, his late brother. They burnt his building down to ashes. It's the other of his brother. They came back the third time. As I'm talking to you now, eight healers driving into that place again. And they burnt all the whole building within that area and used live bullets, shot every building within that community. Came out to the road and burned the whole shops on the road. All the shops line up on the road. They burnt all of them. There is no man and woman in Rift today that did not perceive the kind of heavy gun that they were releasing on air. And everybody there felt because there were a lot of tear gas. And the whole place, if you come to Rift today, as I'm talking to you, it's like ghost burial ground. And there is no pin that can be removed. They do not remove one pin. The whole properties of our lawyer was burned to ashes. That of his late brother, that of his younger brother. Even the new building that they are raising in that place, they've set it ablaze. This is the situation of what is going on here in Omambala, Oripite province. This is the situation we encounter today. As I'm talking to you, they are still fortifying men to come to that place. As I'm talking to you, 8 kilos is passing me now, moving to that environment. And all the...
Yeah, Tony. What to do? No, what to do? Gone.
Okay. So, this is exactly the report on ground. This is the report. You cannot go to his village now and find one person. The whole place is under lock and key. Everybody has packed their belongings and ran away from the community. What you see is the heavy armed policemen, joint force, both Navy and the Army, parading all over the place. You cannot find, there is no bike that is coming to Orif as I'm talking to you now. The ones they caught in the afternoon, they will destroy the bike. And as even there is a reverend father, they told him that the only thing that saved him is just one thing. If not, they could have put bullet on his head. This is exactly the situation on ground as I'm talking to you now.
Mazi Tony.
Mazi?
Yeah, please continue sending those videos and the pictures. Sending those in and bless them, Tony. I repeat, bless them, okay?
Thank you very much.
Appreciate you. Maybe we'll continue. Mazi, I think you are still remaining okay, for me. See you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, my brother. Tony, bless them.
Thank you very much, Mazi. Okay, my brother Tony, you know what I say, play safe. Because your life is very important. Thank you very much. This is Radio Biafra. Hello, Motherland, South Africa. We do it first-hand report. We don't lie like a contraction called zoological. If there is a time, we could have continued. But there is no time. Mazi Nwabeze, can you make it snappy and say a parting shot so that I can leave the platform for our brother, man, or our own African red? I know our people will continue from that. Can you make it snappy? Go ahead, Mazi.
Okay, Mazi, the situation is a state of total hopelessness and helplessness that we find ourselves because we are in this contraction called Nigeria. But I know that we have solace in Biafra, and Biafra will come, and Biafra will restore all things unto us. All that is required of us as Biafrans is to remain resolute, and all that is required of us is to keep focus, and all that is expected of us is to stand firm and resist and fight it out, because we can't run away from our own land. The land belongs to us, it doesn't belong to strangers, the outside Fulanis. So that land is the land of Biafra, belongs to us. So we must defend it and we must possess it. The name of Chukwuka Adeoma.
He said, thank you very much, Mazi. Thank you very much for being with us this night. Thank you very much for reporting what is going on in Omambala. Because we, our leaders say, whatever you hear in Radio Biafra is a simple truth. We don't report fake. We say the way it is. And we have, Chukwuoke Kabiama have made all of us to be a journalist. The zoo called contraction don't have what we have. We are here to take what belongs to us. Thank you very much, Mazi. Thank you very much.